Welcome to HelpYourMath.com. In today's video, we're going to be covering how to make a stem and leaf plot and using the stem and leaf plot to find the range, the mean, the median, and the mode. All right, so the first thing we have to understand when making a stem and leaf plot is that we want to look at every tens digit and every ones digit for all the data and account for each tens place. And each tens place is going to be called the stem, while every ones position is going to be called the leaf. Now, there's a lot of variations for how people actually do this. Some people use commas for every leaf. Some people don't use any commas for the leaf. In this video, we're going to do it without commas. And once I finish the stem and leaf plot, I'm going to insert the commas to show you the difference between what it looks like. However, if you're looking in the textbook, usually every leaf has no comma in between them, okay? And so what we're going to do here then is take account for all the tens place digits here. And we see that we have tens, we have 20s, we have 30s, we have 40s, and we have 50s. So we should have five stems here. So we have a 10, we have a 20, we have a 30, we have a 40, and we have a 50. Now, if your data goes beyond some value, let's say we had a 70 in this, and there were no 60s value, we'll still put in the 6 here and the 7. And next to the 6, there'll be nothing because there's no 60s. Or if in the case of no 70s, there's no 70s. But in this case, we have everything from 10 to maybe like 59. So 50, tens to 50s we have. So every position here is going to have a leaf next to it. And it's fine if the stem doesn't have a leaf. It would just remain empty. In this case, we don't have that situation happening. So now for the stems, we're going to start with the stem of 10. And we're going to look for how many numbers begin with a one digit. So in our case, we have 11, we have 17. And these have to be arranged in order. So our first leaf is going to be 1, and our second leaf is going to be 7, because they have the stem of 10, and these have to go in order. So we have 1 and 7 for the leaves of 1. For the leaves of 2, we have just 26, right? So 25. The value of 25, the leaf for 20, is going to be just the 5. Then we have 30s. So now for 30, we have a 2, we have a 9, we have another 2, and a 0. So we'll start with the 0, followed by 2 2s, and then a 9. We have 0, 2, 2, 9. Now, for the 40s, we have a 6, and we also have a 5 here, so we're going to put 5, followed by a 6. And our last stem is 5, and for 5, we have just the 1. This concludes the stem and leaf component of this video. After we finish this stem and leaf component, what we want to do then is find the range. So to find the range, we take the first stem and leaf and the last stem and leaf. So our first stem and leaf is 11, our last stem and leaf is 51. Now, remembering that the range is the highest value minus the lowest, our highest in this case would be 51, and we're subtracting 11. 51 take away 11 gives us 40. So our range is 40. Let's move on to the mean now. To find the mean, what we have to do is we have to sum all the values up, right? And once we sum these values up, we're going to divide them by the amount of values we have. And here we see on this chart we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10 values. So to get the mean, what we have to do to find x bar is take the sum of every value and divide it by the n. Now, the sum of x, what it represents is that x is every single sample value, and this represents the sum of those samples. So we're just going to go ahead and add them up on the numerator. So we have 25 plus 32 plus 46 plus 11 plus 51 plus 39 plus 45 plus 32, plus 17, plus 30. We're going to divide all of this by the number of samples we have, which I believe to be 10. Right, so when we sum up these values, what we're going to get is, the sum is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. We have 10 values, and the sum of all these digits are going to give us 328. And we're dividing that by 10. All right? So now when we take the sum of these, let me just double check these on a calculation. to make sure our sum is correct. So we have 25 plus 32 plus 46 plus 11 plus 51 plus 39 plus 45 plus 32 plus 17 plus 30. That is 328. So now, make sure you're using a calculator while adding these. Once you add them and you divide them by 10, this division is going to give us 32.8. And 32.8 is our average, our mean, all right? Following the mean, we're going to start by doing the median. Now, to do the median, we have to arrange the data in order. So we're going to go from lowest to highest. Instead of looking at this to do that, we're just going to use our stem and leaf chart. We're going to take each stem with each number and go inserting them here. So we have the first stem and leaf is 1 and 1. The second is going to be 1 and 7. The third, 2 and 5. The fourth, 3, 0. The fifth, 3, 2. The sixth, 3, 2. The seventh, 3, 9. The eighth, 45. The ninth, 46. And the tenth is 51. And this is how useful a stem and leaf chart is. It helps us arrange data in order going from smallest to highest. And what we want to do to get the median is we want to keep knocking one off of each side till we get to the center, right? So we're going to knock off this 11 with this 51. Then we're going to knock off this 17 with this 46 and continue moving in till we close in on two or just one. So the 25 with the 45, the 30 with the 39, and we're left with these two 32s. Now usually since they're the same number, we can just say the median is 32, but what we actually have to do is take both values, in the case our numbers are different, add them up and divide them by 2. So the sum of these makes 64 over 2. Which, when divided by 2, give us 32 again. This produces our median. Now, for the final thing we have to do here is the mode. We want to see which is the most repetitive data on this chart. So we use the stem and leaf chart, and we look at all the leaves and see for any repeating numbers. And in this case, the most repetitive number in this line is 2 and 2, which represent 32 and 32. 32 is the only number that repeats on this list, and so the mode is 32. Thank you.